Cities, you cities.
It's cities. Agreed then?
Great.
Finally, Money Heist returned with the fourth season. 167 million viewers in more than 190 countries were waiting for the show to continue. Impressive, huh? However, the series hasn't always been that successful. How has the project on the verge of cancellation turned into the most popular foreign language show on Netflix? Which world-famous personality became obsessed with the show? Is it true that the script was written by the actors? Which character was created by a complete coincidence, and which one was inspired by a film icon? Why did one of the cast members post a video of him crying? What is the meaning behind the character's outfits? Stay with us to discover all the unknown facts about the show-making process and its cast. But be aware of spoilers. And don't forget to subscribe to Rumor Juice YouTube channel for other exciting showbiz stories. The show was initially a flop. You're probably aware of the series' original Spanish title, La Casa de Papel, which means paper house. However, it wasn't the creator's first choice. At the very beginning, the series was titled with a Spanish term that means hopeless or irredeemable. The idea was to emphasize that the crew consisted of social rejects, but eventually the creator gave it up. La Casa de Papel was launched in 2017 on a free Spanish TV channel. The show had 4.5 million viewers at the time. Not great, not terrible. However, this number was only decreasing. Both the creators and the actors had already accepted it was a flop, but then all of a sudden, the show was licensed, renamed to Money Heist, and recut from 15 to 22 episodes by Netflix. And guess what? The number of viewers increased drastically. So did the number of people who followed the cast members on social media. The actors didn't know what had caused such a change, but they presumed something was happening. Indeed, something was happening. A blast, to be precise. In April 2020, Money Heist became the most in-demand series in the world, beating even Game of Thrones. Unexpected obsession. As of today, Money Heist is the most viewed non-English show on Netflix. People are obsessed with the series and perceive it as a page-turner in the world of cinematic arts.
Thank you for being here, for your respect.
It's interesting that the show is addictive, even to the ones who create real page-turners.
Folks, my next guest is a best-selling author who has been scaring you for over 40 years.
The biggest name among those obsessed with Money Heist is probably American author Stephen King. Here's what he tweeted in August 2019. Okay, Netflix, you left me hanging. When does Money Heist come back? Because dig it, I'm not getting any younger here. He also shared a photo of himself wearing a mask, similar to the one all the gang members wear. By the way, after the show's release, red jumpsuits and Salvador Dali masks became the symbol of resistance, in the real world as well. People wore them during protests in Lebanon, Iraq, France, Chile, and Puerto Rico. But why exactly red jumpsuits and Salvador Dali masks? Wait for the answer to this question at the end of the video. Now let's focus on another thing popularized by the series.
Partizano, porta mi vida.
The Bella Ciao song had served as a hymn of protest long before Money Heist, for example during World War II, and it's just one of many cultural and historical references hidden in the show. It might seem that the creators thought of everything, even the smallest details. Well, they didn't. They don't have scripts, sometimes. It's probably the most shocking fact about Money Heist, but scripts for the series were not written in advance. They're being created alongside filming. Not always, though. There were at least 50 different scenarios of the show's pilot episode, until the creators agreed on the one they all found perfect. Eventually, they decided to have more space for improvisation. Well, a lot of space for improvisation. According to the writers, their main goal now is to understand what a script calls for. In other words, if an actor or the director captures something truly remarkable, the show can change on a dime. Itziar Ituño, who played Lisbon, explains it as follows. They were writing the chapters as we went along. We didn't know how it was going to end, and we kept wondering until almost the very end. For example, season 3 features a flashback where the professor teaches his students to perform surgery in case of an emergency. Once he brings out a dead pig to practice on, fearless hitman Marseille immediately refuses to follow his instructions. You wonder why? It turns out that Luca Peros, who plays Marseille, is an animal rights activist. The actor couldn't get over his principles for the role. As the season progressed, the creators benefited a lot from this unexpected character development. Marseille's bond with animals became his humanizing element. Also, it allowed him to build an emotional connection with the grieving professor. The professor you didn't know.
The professor. No criminal record, no registration. Hasn't renewed his ID since he was 19. For all intents and purposes, a ghost.
Initially, the professor was supposed to be absolutely different. The show's creator once explained that he saw this character as a loser and an old bumbling academic. However, the professor ended up being a mysterious criminal genius and a charismatic Robin Hood-style anti-hero. Arguably, the professor, played by Alvaro Morte, is one of the reasons people are addicted to the series. The actor transferred some of his personal qualities to his on-screen character. Still, they don't have much in common. Morte prefers a quiet and peaceful life to ventures of any kind. He has been happily married for years and shares two twin children with his beautiful wife. Morte told Metro Journal that he feels grateful for being on Money Heist, but he doesn't want the success to have a bad impact on his life. The show star is getting a lot of acting proposals now, but he is very picky. During a promotional panel for the Peer series, where he had a lead role, Alvaro said he had a hard time stepping into his character's shoes. "I was afraid of playing such a polyamorous character. He was a man who's cheating on his wife. I thought he should go to hell, but that's part of the challenge." Well, it looks like he nailed all the challenges associated with this role and kept doing his best as the Money Heist professor. In the meantime, other actors can only dream of landing such a gig, and we are not exaggerating. For instance, one Bollywood star recently shared a video on Instagram in which he plays the Bella Chow song on a piano. Here's how he captioned the video. "I want to be the professor. That's why I'm wearing similar glasses and playing Bella Chow. I want to put this out in the universe. Hello, reverend filmmakers, are you listening? Please, I'm dying to do something like this."
Interesting.
We can only wish him good luck. Now, let's focus on another example of a lucky coincidence.
Nairobi, a hardened optimist.
How Nairobi was born. Alba Flores, the actress who played Nairobi, revealed how the showrunner created her character. While writing the script, he realized there was just one female character, Tokyo. He sent the script of the first episode to Alba Flores and asked whether she liked it. She actually did like it, so the creator decided to come up with another role, specifically for her. That's how Nairobi was born. Flores's character was probably the heart of the squad and the only cool-headed person in the group. No wonder Nairobi ended up having so many fans. "I was recently in the street, and a teenage girl came to me and said, 'Please take a picture with me. I'm so excited that I'm going to get your face tattooed on my arm.'" Apparently, somewhere in the world there's a girl with Nairobi's face on her arm. That's what we call a cult. By the way, some characters of the show root back to other cult movies. You've seen Tokyo before. You've already guessed, right? Tokyo was inspired by Matilda from the 1994 film Leon the Professional. Played by Natalie Portman, Matilda became a legend, and for Ursula Corberó, in particular. She took a vast amount of inspiration from the iconic character. It explains why some of Tokyo's outfits were finished off with a choker, and why she has a short bob cut with bangs. Whether you love or hate Tokyo, it's Ursula Corberó who brings this character to life. In the real world, Ursula is a fashion icon. If you follow the actress on Instagram, you're probably fascinated by her brilliant outfits. And you're not the only one. And what about other actors' Instagrams? Creepy Instagram video. In 2019, the followers of Miguel Herrán, who plays Rio, came across one concerning video. He shed tears in front of the camera without saying a word. Basically, the 23-year-old just sobbed in silence. Here's how he captioned the clip. "I'm not going to go into the details of what is happening to me because I don't even know it myself." What would that mean? This face distorted by sadness is the exact opposite of the smiling photos that the young man usually shares with his followers. Many were concerned that Miguel was clinically depressed and needed help. However, it turned out that this video was not more than the actor's protest against lies. "I could post 1,000 of great photos to feed this lying machine called Instagram. I could inflate my ego and fill my void with likes. But not today. I decided to give you an honest part of myself. That's just how I feel right now. No filters, no sweetener, no lies." Now it makes sense. Apparently, Herrán decided to share his bad days along with the good ones. That's brave. What can we say? Hypnotizing paintings.
"This is a beautiful moment."
Pedro Alonso, who plays Berlin, doesn't post such candid videos, but his Instagram is notable for something else. It seems like painting is a fundamental part of the actor's life. Besides, he's also a writer and has been planning to publish a book about a Roman spy. And it's not even the first book he wrote, but apparently it will be the first one to be published. Another interesting fact is that Pedro wants to illustrate the book together with his girlfriend. Pedro is in a relationship with Tixie Jambas, who is a hypnotherapist, and also an artist, apparently. Does it mean that the couple will soon hypnotize us with their art? We hope so.
All the kisses of the life for you, for everyone.
Hidden meaning behind the outfits. Last but not least, we've already figured out that the gang members' outfits became iconic, but what do they actually mean? According to one of the interviews with Alvaro Morte, the group wasn't targeting the Royal Mint in the first season to obtain money. It was most likely an act of resistance against the system. Apparently, jumpsuits in Money Heist support the show's core theme of revolution, for red is a bold color, often associated with resistance. What about the masks, then? Their meaning is kind of the same. Spanish surrealist Salvador Dalí became the symbol of revolution and rebellion in art, so his image is used for a reason. Everything comes together now, right? Oh well, it seems that real-life stories around Money Heist are as intense as the show itself. Thankfully, intense doesn't always mean criminal, dirty, and dangerous.